I swear to God, I just saw infantry in the game. Yes, I know infantry exist in War Thunder, but I've never seen them actually in a match before. Only in custom battles, and in flight tests. But I swear to God, I just saw a group of German, or I'm sorry, Russian infantry on the ground here. Or which would technically be the Chinese infantry. So TB3s fly over. Yeah, look right there. We got frickin' infantry on the ground. What? And why is there a delay? I don't have delay on. Hey, I didn't know that there were infantry now. Now please do it for ground forces, because I still call false advertisement on Gaijin, because their trailer for War Thunder shows infantry charging around with little tanks in ground forces battles when there are absolutely no infantry in ground force battles yet. Shit. I'm gonna have to get this guy with my special. Yeah, nice, okay. Okay, now that is a leg three. The kind of shit that I didn't want to get into a battle with, but because it's against the Russians, it's full of 20mm cannon aircraft. Oh. Of course he's unconscious. It's not surprising. Yeah, I knew this match wasn't going to go very well for me. Constant enemy aircraft with their fucking goddamn 20 mils. I haven't been in any match with any guys with 20mm cannons, and then all of this, besides the H6K, and then all of a sudden it puts me in a Russian match. And I predicted that with Gaijin's speciality in making Russians have super low battle ratings, I knew for a fact there was going to be shit with cannons, but it seems that I have managed to survive here, and I'm going to make another pass on those. I've got a leak, but it's not bad. And thanks to my team, who's actually covering my ass, which is pretty good, but I don't know, there's too many other Russians here. I'm losing altitude. What the hell is all this bullshit? I should get some bombs back in repair, but like, what the fuck is the point in that? Now, was my special act? Yeah, my fucking goddamn 50 cal was knocked out. What the hell, guys? Unfair bullshit. Okay, where is... Okay, airfield's back this way. I'm just hoping that our team can hold the enemy off for a little while I make a run back to the damn airfield. Again, I mean, I've got a couple different clips I'm posting. You know, shorter episodes, shorter little clips like this. But if you haven't watched the other ones or seen them, the reason I'm flying such low tier is because I'm trying to elite. Right now, I know I said I was going to work on eliting after I was done getting all the vehicles of the tech trees, but right now, I haven't been doing much luck with ground forces, for the top tier ground forces, so I just said, you know what, how about I just take a break and grind some modifications for some aircraft. And, you know, I usually always start with the lowest tier thing that I don't have elite and then work my way up the tier, or down the tiers. Well, technically up the tiers. And I got the... I eliteed the D3A1 and the H6K already. They were already eliteed, but they released the engine injection modification last patch. And now I'm working on the KI-21, which was completely stocked. Played one match, did like absolutely nothing but got an assist and unlocked like six modifications, so I'm assuming that this match is going to turn out a lot better in terms of actual reward. Now we do have a leg chasing a KI-45 back, and I'm hoping this KI-43 here that's now taking off, I believe, yeah, even though it looks really bad because of the new view system, and we got this KI-43 over here who seems to be doing loops and stalling out, and I don't know what he's doing. It is low tier matches. I don't want to drop my engine on that right now. Oh, maybe he's trying to... he might be trying to break speed. I guess I just realized. Okay. Well, I mean, some of these guys are actually... Like, he's Falcon. He's got a Tier 5 Russian. So be it. This is realistic battles, by the way. If it wasn't obvious already. Keep I was going to do arcade, and I might do arcade sometimes, but right now I'm going to try and stick with realistic battles, because, I don't know, I like the immersion a little more, and I haven't been flying much realistic lately, so I really need to get back to it. And it looks like we have a textbook landing here. Ooh, oh, I thought I was coming down a little too hard there, but no, it's fine. That Ki-43 has bellied herself. Propeller is bent back there. Look at that. It's beautiful, though. It's beautiful that you can do that. There we go. Ki-21 has successfully landed. And there is a crashed aircraft there underground, which you can now see through my plane. That's another bug. 21 seconds. Yeah, my Japanese crews are not good. They really need some beefing, but flying them in this particular crew will help beef them up. I decided to go with the Japanese because I have the least amount of units for them and the least amount of elites, I believe, for out of the nations. So I decided to go with them for right now. And that leg 3 is still out there dueling with a Ki-43, which should have absolutely no problem in taking down a leg 3 with its maneuverability, but I don't know, he could be damaged, who knows. Yeah, it's just me and two Ki-43s against that one guy, that one leg. Come on, Ki-43, you can do it. Unlike a lot of other bombers, this one doesn't have a gun pointing forward, only a gun pointing down in the front. If it had a gun pointing forward, I would like to try to help out and get... Oh yeah, that Ki-43 is right on that leg 3's ass. I probably won't get to drop any more bombs this match. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. And there's that... I guess he wasn't bleeding speed because he's now doing it again, but we win. Okay. Oh well, you know, shit happens. There's that plane again. Down there. Interesting. Loot. Boop 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 boop. Alright, finally got some ground target kills. Instead of just going into a match and doing nothing, but at least not dying. Well, I could have died there. I'm surprised I didn't. Oh yeah, 994 is going to give me a lot of modifications. I'll get my engine upgrade. It costs a billion Silver Lions to purchase. Now this thing has... Oh, it doesn't have a 50 cal. It just has a dual 30 cal, but it sounds more powerful. I thought it had a 50 cal. My bad. I guess... Yeah, but it doesn't tell me what fucking one. It just... Ugh, son of a bitch. I don't know which one, because I was going to upgrade that. Well, what does wing... engine injection. Now, cover, I believe, it increases... Yeah, overall plane durability, so I'm going to spend a chunk of my RP on that. I have available 1,220. So I'm going to go for engine injection as well. Might have to play one more match. Well, actually, go for compressor. Wings repair. Fuselage repair. Turret 7. Yeah, I'm going to have to go one more match. And then we should have it. Ooh, now, I saw the one for the Tiger when you research all modifications, but I haven't seen this one, so I'm going to snap a screenshot. Pretty neat. Alright, one more match, and this thing should be elite, and that's three more vehicles elite for my Japanese, and I get to move on to Tier 2, which contains... Oh, good, I actually get to fly some fighters, but it also contains two bombers. Two more bombers! Which, one of them has a fair amount of modifications, and the other one is almost completely finished. Okay, so that's good to see. The JE2 M2, I think, is... Yeah, almost completely stock. Well, it is stock, but I have flown it. And the Ki-44, I have never flown. Even in arcade, I've never flown it. Because I forgot it even existed. When I was looking through the planes earlier today, I was just like looking through the tech tree. I'm like, the fuck is the Ki-44? And I looked at it, and I'm like, holy shit, this is one of the ugliest planes I've seen. And I'm like, wow. you know, so it'll be interesting trying to give that another go. Oh, god damn it. When I get Steam notifications, it's hard to find where the fucking back button is. Alright guys, thanks for watching. See you in a future, boobs.